Old Man Shaw was unhappy enough that night to have satisfied even Mrs. Blewett, had she known. He saw himself as he thought White Sands folk must see him, a poor, shiftless, foolish old man who had only one thing in the world worth while, his little girl, and had not been of enough account to keep her. "Oh, Blossom, Blossom," he said, and when he spoke her name it sounded as if he spoke the name of one dead. After a little, the worst sting passed away. He refused to believe long that Blossom would be ashamed of him. He knew she would not. 3 years could not so alter her loyal nature, no, nor 10 times 3 years. But she would be changed. She would have grown away from him in those 3 busy, brilliant years. His companionship could no longer satisfy her. How simple and childish he had been to expect it! She would be sweet and kind. Blossom could never be anything else. She would not show open discontent or dissatisfaction. She would not be like Loretta Bradley. But it would be there, and he would divine it, and it would break his heart. Mrs. Blewett was right. When he had given Blossom up, he should not have made a half-hearted thing of his sacrifice. He should not have bound her to come back to him. He walked about in his little garden until late at night, under the stars, with the sea crooning and calling to him down the slope. When he finally went to bed, he did not sleep, but lay until morning with tear-wet eyes and despair in his heart. All the forenoon he went about his usual daily work absently. Frequently he fell into long reveries, standing motionless wherever he happened to be, and looking dully before him. Only once did he show any animation. When he saw Mrs. Blewett coming up the lane, he darted into the house, locking the door, and listened to her knocking in grim silence. After she had gone, he went out and found a plate of fresh doughnuts, covered with a napkin, placed on the bench at the door. Mrs. Blewett meant to indicate thus that she bore him no malice for her curt dismissal the day before. Possibly her conscience gave her some twinges also. But her doughnuts could not minister to the mind she had diseased. Old Man Shaw took them up, carried them to the pig pen, and fed them to the pigs. It was the first spiteful thing he had done in his life, and he felt a most immoral satisfaction in it.